July 16. To Internal Security Commission, Ray Skyhook. Summary and progress report from Project Director Dr. Russell A. Marvin.
And Mrs. Dr. Russell A. Marvin, without whose inspiration and untiring criticism, this report could never have been written.
Now, please, no interruptions. Because of recent scientific advances, it is now possible to realize an ancient dream, the exploration of outer space. To prepare for this great stride forward, we are assembling data on conditions at atmospheric levels beyond those hitherto explored. To collect the necessary data, unmanned automatic observation posts are being sent up in multiple stage rockets to a distance hundreds of miles above the Earth's surface. There, swinging in endless orbits around our planet, will be 12 tiny man-made satellites, or moons. They will report to us by radio, thus providing primary information needed to prepare the way for our ascent into space. The effects of gravitational loss, showers of meteoric dust, the fierce and undiluted heat of the sun, the cosmic radiation, all will be studied and analyzed. At the present time, we have launched 10 of the artificial satellites, or birds as we call them. Do you hear something?
Hear what? It was a saucer. A flying saucer?
Well, we saw what appeared to be a flying saucer. That's all we can say.
We saw it. We heard it, both of us. What more do we need to know?
Well, we have to have time to think, to evaluate this, before we sound off.
Let me have a light.
You people should take better care of yourselves. Stop poisoning your bodies with tobacco and atom bombs. Sooner or later, that kind of stuff will kill you.
Of course, it wasn't a saucer at all. I just shake like this all the time.
Or birds, as we call them.
The saucer sound. It's on the tape. You forgot to turn it off. I remember now. I turned it off afterwards.
Well, that's one piece of concrete evidence.
Hi, Barney.
Oh, hi, Annie.
This is Mr. Maxwell from New York. Mr. Maxwell, this is our sheriff, Andy Tater, and his deputy, Barney Fife.
Oh,
how do you do, sir?
How are you?
Hello, deputy.
You salesman, are you?
Oh, no, this isn't a sample case. This is a portable tape recorder.
Mr. Maxwell makes recordings of folk songs all over the world. He might want to do an album with some of the people around here.
Oh, I expect that'd tickle everybody, don't you, Barney?
Hey, this is the first time I ever seen one of these doohickeys in the flesh. How they work?
Well, let me give you a demonstration. Sheriff, have you got an outlet around here?
Yeah, good place right over here.
Well, here's the microphone. Yeah. All we have to do is plug it in.
Got a mic and everything.
Turn it on.
Huh.
Now here, deputy, you hold that in your hand. Now go ahead. Say something right into the mic.
Project Blue Book, case number 1501. Records that at 9:35 a.m. on the 16th of July, 1952, U.S. Coast Guard photographer Seaman Shell Alpert observed the appearance of several very bright lights in the sky. This was through a window screen with no glass from his photolab within Coast Guard Air Station Salem, Massachusetts. He watched the lights for 6 seconds and called them to the attention of Hospitalman First Class Thomas E. Flaherty, who was in the sick bay. The objects dimmed, then suddenly brightened, and Alpert grabbed a camera to film 4 roughly elliptical, irregular blobs of light in formation, apparently pointing at the pollution emanating from the stacks of the coal-fired power plant of Salem Harbor Station, which had just started operation in 1951.